I tweeted you, but you ain't responded. I messaged you on Facebook and sent email correspondence. I left you comments on your Instagram, and you just ignored him. Ever since you got the Daily Show, I guess you're too important. Selfies with Chris Rock and Lenny Kravitz? Yo, you out there boarding. But anyway, what's been up? How's Jerry Seinfeld, dude? I did a show with Lisa Gola, so I'm almost famous too. By the way, if you ever want to go out for a movie, Drew, my gran's a fan. So is it cool if she comes through too? We watch your DVDs every night, and she's besotted now. Anyway, I tweeted you my number, so you've got it now. Please go ahead and send me a text so we can make a plan. Me, you, and Gran. This is your bestest friend, Deep Fried Man.
She's so old, I'm wondering how I got stuck working here between her and her creepy grandson. I wish he'd disappear. I thought my old job at the nursing home was the worst I'd ever had. In comparison, it was not so bad, not so bad.
Dear Trev, please get back to me. I've seen that you've been tweeting. That's fine. I just think it's history repeating. Like that time I asked you to my party on the weekend. You didn't come. I drank a fifth of rum and fell off the deep end. It's cool though. I'm not saying you're to blame. But there was no one there. We could have made out if you came. You see, I'm just like you in a way. I'm also a comedian. And many women find us both appealing. You host the Daily Show. I watch the Daily Show sometimes. You're half white. I'm also half white, but on both sides. And I relate to what you're saying in your comedy. I admit occasionally that's a turn on for me. Sometimes I put on lipstick, a tiara and a feather boa, and spend my evenings dancing with a blow-up doll called Trevor Noah. I even make us dinner, apple pie and chicken cordon bleu. My grandma's jealous, cause I said I love you more than her. You've gotta call me, man, or I will start texting you my dick. Sincerely yours, Deep Fried Man. P.S. Right now I'm touching it.
I think Trevor's wondering why some guy called Deep Fried Man.
If you were busy Thursday, we can make another plan. It's not too much to ask to compensate me for this pain, is it? You'll be sending me a backstage pass and a plane ticket. Or I will kidnap you unless you put me on TV. It will be like a scene from Scorsese's King of Comedy. You see, Trev? Shut up, Gran, I'm trying to rhyme. Yes, Trev, that's my grandma tied up in the kitchen. I'm about to chop her up so that you'll never get to meet her. I'll film her with a camera while I cook her up and eat her. And then I'll take the footage straight to YouTube and post this shit. On second thoughts, maybe not. What if I don't get hits?
Oy vey, that escalated quickly. I'm glad we all survived. My greatest fear is next time Grandma won't make it out alive. So Trevor Noah, if you're hearing this, please send him a reply.
Deep Fried Man, this is Trevor Noah's publicist. Just mailing you to give you an idea of how messed up this is. I ran this all past Trevor and he's never heard of you. How dare you insinuate that he somehow deserted you? Your words are the absurd exaggerations of some pervy dude. And if the type of libel is continued, we'll surely sue. It's pointless too, it's not as if you got money. Maybe you would, if like Trevor you were funny. You wanna know the only thing that really made us laugh? Was your request for plane tickets and a backstage pass. Sure, then pigs will fly and it'll rain quarters. The only thing we'll be sending is a restraining order.
Disclaimer, we apologize to Trevor.